This is for my job interview. My weaknesses are dementia. Lack of self-control. Insomnia. Strengths are confidence and group leader. Oh, is he from Ohio?
Eminem.
Oh,
wait a minute. Oh my God, skull emoji. Yeah?
Ozone destruction.
What about it?
Do that.
The assignment?
Yeah.
I'll be right there.
Shh.
I'll blur your face.
What'd you say?
Are you gonna blur my voice too?
This drawing, guys. So majestic. Tell me what's going on here.
Santa Claus on fire.
Only in Ohio. God damn. Only in Ohio.
Is that YouTube?
That's not YouTube. Bro, oh my God.
How's your favorite class?
This is downloading. Oh my.
Bro.
You can't click?
What do you think about Squid Games?
I'm saying yo. I didn't like it. I'm boring. How'd it go? You like? The intro? Did you watch it?
No.
No?
I never watched Squid Games.
What is your opinion with people who have watched Squid Games? You have a problem with them?
No, not at all.
What do you have to say about your viewers that watch Squid Games?
Go you.
What about Breaking Bad?
If you watch Breaking Bad? Yeah.
Lizzo wanna be eat so bad? I
these are the same.
Me and
D.
No.
They're
not the same.
Me and D are the same.
They're not the same because they have different letters. B and D.
This is Elon Musk.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have 100. I got it 100. What can I say? I'm a graduate to Harvard. Scholar. Way out here. An advisory. Take a picture. So, we out here in advisory today. I work in real estate and stuff like that. I'm a trillionaire. Some people call me a John D. Rockefeller for a reason. My nickname is actually they call me D for John D. Rockefeller. That's my nickname. My friends call me that. I have a lot of friends, by the way. This is one of them. Say hi.
I'm tired, bro.
We're gonna cut that out. We're gonna try again. Say hi.
Ni hao.
He's an exchange student.
Oh, he's recording.
Yeah, he's recording.
Let me get his number.
I have not been talking to the mic. I've been talking to the charger hole. Okay. What do you want? Let me
take the mic. Alright. How tall is too tall in the guy?
5'8".
How tall are you?
6 feet.
How tall do you think I am?
Like
5'4".
5'5". In a good day, like around 5'12".
On a good day?
Yeah.
5'12"?
How much you mashallah can then book it? Can I bag you?
No.
You trying to do something strange for a piece of change?
I can't fucking do this, man. Oh my god. Okay, so this is today. Is it B-Day? We are in the Northwest campus. We have infiltrated the campus. Oh, there's the bell. Yeah, point at the bell. Zoom in at the bell. Zoom at the bell. That's the bell, guys.
When it rang.
Oh my god. Record. Keep recording. We're gonna walk.
Wow.
Record me.
Oh my god.
Record me.
What the? Who's that?
Record.
Fine.
Keep recording. Hold on. What? I'm gonna make this as awkward as possible.
Oh.
Yeah. This is Tony. He's my best friend.
Welcome. Hola, yo soy María Ángela Arriaga.
She photobombed my video. This is horrible. All right, I'm paying you 10 hours. I mean, 10. I'm paying you $10. My vlog. School.
What is your vlog for?
School.
Oh.
Oh, y'all hear that? Shitty ass podcast. I ain't finna cap. They talk about like fucking. I'm kidding. That's way too political. I can't say that. That's too controversial. I fired my. What is it called? I fired my best man for the job.
Cameraman.
My cameraman. Record him. I'll blur out your face, don't worry. And then behind the camera we have
Justine.
One word. Carrots. My bad. Record him. That's my friend. Hola, Miss. Recorder. Hola, Miss.
Hola.
I'll blur your face. No worry. I got you. We're out here in Spanish. Voy a hablar español ahora. Porque esta clase nomás se habla español. No se preocupen. Voy a poner subtítulos para mis fans.
Want us to come over.
Oh, yeah, this weekend?
Oh, yeah. When are we going to go to... When Saturday? Today?
Yeah. How late can y'all stay? There's no school Friday.
10.
Y'all trying to sleep over?
Sure. Butt booty naked?
Hell yeah, the only way.
God.
It's a sign.
Oh. He finished. Alright, gang. So, I'll see you back in the next... Later. Are you gonna Oh, hi. I didn't see you there. I'm out here at the church. I'm doing community hours, service hours, whatever. I volunteered to clean the church and sweep the floor. I'm not even sweeping the floor right. Hold up. Oh, you want to see some of my sweeping skills? Like I learned it from my mom. I'm a mama's boy. Look. Hey, contract me. If you want a maid at your house, hit me up. I'll clean your whole house, interior and outside. Oh yeah, I also have a business for like to cut grass. It's called Juan Pablo's Lawnmower Simulator. That's the name of my business. We currently are hiring. I am the only one who's working there, and I made the company. I'm basically like the CEO of the company. So come work for me if you want to work with me. We're going to be like buddies or like a trio or squad, you know, like Fortnite. If you want to be part of my squad, just hit me up, you know. Like, oh shit. Oh, hold up. If you want to be part of my squad, just hit me up. We're going to drop in at people's houses, like especially old people. Old people will give you more money or not. Like some old people are just grumpy. Like this, I remember this one time, there was this bald guy, this bald, grumpy old man. He just answered the door, and I was like, Juan Pablo's business simulator, do you want us to cut your grass? What's it called? He was like, no. And I was like, yeah, please, come on, sir. I'm doing this for the community. I'm doing this for the service. And he was like, okay. And I was like, okay, bet. And then I lasted there for like 5 hours, bro. Like 5 hours. It's not that much, but you know, hard work out there, bro. Like literally, I was sweating the whole time. Like I dead ass. Like it was so uncomfortable. You know, like, okay, so this is like for men right here, real quick. Well, if you're a girl, you can listen to. I'm not gonna like, you know, discriminate. Yo, if your name is Juan Pablo, I'm sorry for using your name, bro. But like, I gotta use it, okay? Hopefully that motherfucker doesn't copyright claim my fucking video. Why am I saying bad words, bro? I'm at church. Near church. Me perdona, Diosito Santo, por favor, bro. Some people say I'm a little bit narcissistic. I'd say no, because narcissistic is something that Playboy Cardi will do. I'll never be Playboy Cardi. What am I talking about, bro? I'm sorry. People must not see what I be saying behind the scenes, you know? Something very, very bad, very dangerous. I'm just kidding. I don't see nothing bad up behind the scenes, right, Betty?
For the most part, yeah.
Most part? Hold up. What do you mean by that?
I mean, we'd be cursing in church, so.
True, Betty. True, very true. I repent for my sins. Actually, no me he confesado. No me he confesado. Huh? Really? You haven't either? My guy. But yeah, no me he confesado. And the reason why is because if I confess, the fucking, what's it called? Who's the manager? Who's the person that we must tell or confess to? El padre? How did I not know that? That's so... I shouldn't even be coming to church school, bro. Like, oh my God. Last time I came to church school was in another church, not in this church. Because this church is usually, like, very strict. Is it... Do you say it's strict, Betty?
Not really.
Not really? I feel like in this church, it's not strict, but, like, they order more from you. And I don't want to do that, man. The one that I went last time is by near my house, which is by a bank. It's the bank by Chase, you know, the Chase by Little York Road, all the way over there. Yeah, all the way over there. And then there's like a church right next to that bank. I went there when I was a little kid, when I was like, what, 12? 12 years old? No, 12, 13, 14, 15. Yeah, 12 years old. Took 3 years. Actually, I'm not 15 no more. I'm 16. Oh, yeah. Boing, boing, boing. All right, let's talk about politics. So,
I would usually talk about John D. Rockefeller and how he became a trillionaire, but we learned that in school. Actually, I learned that before. What's up, Betty? Is there somebody at the door? Hold up. Don't worry, Betty. I got you. Hold up. Hold up. There's nobody outside. We good? Dude, I have not been sweeping. Look at all this garbage. Point at it, Betty. Point at this garbage, bro. Oh my God. I have not done anything. All I've done is just talk. Well, honestly, I have been doing something. I've been sweeping the garbage into the middle. So, as you can see, I'm pro sweeper. The way I learned it is from, from House Flipper. It's basically on Xbox. And I played House Flipper. Like, I would do like 16-hour gaming sessions over House Flipper. It was amazing back then, you know? Back when I was like, when I weighed like 300 pounds. And I had this gamer chair. I sweat on that gamer chair so much. The guy just went back into his office, so we good. And I sweat so much in that gaming chair. I remember like my butt stain was on that shit. And it was like, legendary, bro. Okay, yeah, we were talking about politics. Well, I was talking about politics. Usually I would talk about John D. Rockefeller, but then we learned it at school, man. But keep in mind, Take a picture. All right, that's enough of pictures. I learned about John D. Rockefeller before we learned it at school, bro. I'm just that smart, huh? So basically, no, I'm not gonna talk about John D. Rockefeller. Most people know about him. And if you don't know about him, well, shit, I don't know what to tell you. Our U.S. history teacher, he, like, showed us and everything. So I'm pretty sure most people know who he is. Like, people at least should know that he's a trillionaire. Or, like, the first person to, like, become a trillionaire back in the old days. And I already stated before that my friends call me John D. They call me D. My nickname is D for John D. Rockefeller. The reason why I wasn't be able to record last period from yesterday, it was because it was horrible. I took out the video I was gonna put. I mean, I did record a little bit from last period, but it was only a little bit, and I just recorded like me and Danilo watching Jeffrey Dahmer on Netflix, and that was it. I ain't trying to call out nobody, but like somebody was recording my thingy, and he kept stopping. And it was horrible. I had to edit the whole thing. And the recording, from the mic, I had it on the whole time. So I had to cut it in little pieces, little parts. It was horrible. It lasted for at least like 1 hour and 57 minutes, I want to say. Almost 2 hours editing. Please drop a like or comment down below. Please. I'm out here struggling. I'm unemployed. I'm just kidding. I might apply to Marshall's because Juanito works there, and Juanito's funny as fuck. So I'm gonna cope with him. Plus, what's it called? Marshall's is paying $11 an hour, I think. Pretty sure $11 an hour. Bathrooms are really bad, dude, in Marshall's, especially at Ross, right? If you go to Ross, I don't know what to tell you, bro. Like, you know who you are. I'm just saying, Marshall, not trying to be political out here, but like I'm just saying my opinion. No, it's a fact, to be exact. To be quite frank with you, like on the low key, like on my mama, like high key, like metaphorically, like I'm just saying, like Marshall's is better than Ross. That's just my opinion. Cause every time I go to Ross, there is nothing there. I'm telling you, there's nothing there. There's nothing. I hate Ross so much. But, well, both Marshall's and Ross, I hate them, but, like, Marshall's is, like, my... I hate it, but I'll still go, because, you know, I like the sweaters there, and I like the t-shirts in there. They're funny as fuck. They got this, like, cartoonish stuff in there, or, like, childish stuff. Well, guys, that was kind of scary, I didn't think. There's ghosts in here. Actually, no, there's no ghosts in here. Only the Holy Spirit is here. I usually buy my stuff at Marshall's, not at Ross. Ross is like, I've never gone to like a Ross. The last time I went to Ross, like a Ross, what's it called? A restroom or bathroom, whatever you guys name it. What's it called? It was gross as hell, man. Like, oh, God damn. There's more like all types of food, like fish, fucking cheese. Oh my God, that's horrible. Like when I go to Marshall's, it's all right. I don't have to pee in there because, you know, Marshall's knows me. When I go to Marshall's, I never pee in there because I don't have to. But always, not always, but like sometimes when I go to Ross, I gotta pee. And what's it called? I don't know, bro. I feel like every time I go to Marshall's, I go, like there's a curse on me. I feel like the security guard cursed me with like a curse in there when I walked into Ross. Because he was like, good morning. And I was like, I don't know, bro. He might have put a curse on me or something. Because like every time I go there now, I gotta go pee. And then every time I go to the bathroom, horrible, bro. It's horrible. Nobody should ever encounter that. There was like a ton of toilet paper down. It's kind of like school, but like way worse. It's horrible. Oh yeah, and Juanito, he basically cleans the toilet, but not really, because so according to him, they're already clean because they look shiny. Like if he sees a little sparkle on them, he's like, they're clean. Don't worry about it. He does nothing about it. Take a picture. I don't think that I talk that deep about stuff. I feel like OJ Simpson did not. No, yes, he did. The fuck am I talking about? I feel like OJ Simpson did do it. Even though some people say that he did not do it. I say that he did it. The whole evidence was there, but like the dudes who were taking care of the evidence like fucked it up like completely. Like the gloves that OJ Simpson was wearing in the killing, they fucked it up. They messed it up so bad. Like the dudes who were taking care of him, I already said that. They messed it up like really bad. And then in the courtroom, they were making him put on the gloves if they fit right, and they didn't. They fit really tight on him. And the reason why is because the dudes left them on the refrigerator for too long, and it messed up the whole thing, the whole case. And basically, he won because of that. And he killed he murdered his ex-wife. He like stabbed her like 72 times, I think. And I was like, damn, how mad do you have to be to like stab her? I'm not sure why he stabbed her. I think I do know why, but like. Or he was just jealous, or he just wanted to kill her or something like that. Because they had a divorce, and then she started seeing somebody immediately after they divorced. And then he was like, I bet, let me kill this woman. Ooh, Pitti, have you heard about the Maria Nemeth case? Where the guy ripped her insides out? Like, devoured her from here? It was horrible, dude. I saw the whole case. I was so... Ugh. But I wasn't that gross. Well, I was kind of gross. I was kind of. I'm not squeamish or anything like that. I just feel like kind of like creepy, you know, or like disturbing. But it was kind of like like chills, you know, like from your thing. Come on, man. Horrible. And the reason why, and I still don't know if this is true. It's because the reason why he did that is because he was so angry at her because when they were having, and she yelled out her ex's name. I know, it's crazy. It's wild. Honestly, if that happened to me, I would have been like, huh? I wouldn't have done that. I wouldn't have done that, but I would have been like, okay. Shit. Let me start yelling out fucking my ex's name. I'm gonna be yelling it, bro. I'm not even moaning. Oh no, it slipped out. Whatever, bro. Whatever. I'm gonna be crying, but at the same time, I'll be like, get over here. I won't do anything bad, I swear. I swear, I will not do anything bad. I'm not those type of people. Those people are crazy, bro. Not me, though. I just talk to myself and, like, talk to myself, you know? Sometimes you gotta talk to a real one. Damn, Betty, my throat is getting fucking dry as fuck, dude. Need some water. Agua. If I committed something, like, anything, straight up, like, tell the truth, I'd be like, yes, I did that, and this and that. Call Saul Goodman. He's a good lawyer. I know him. You know, we actually met at the bar. We were talking about our wives and stuff like that, and like how much money we make, and like business related stuff, and like what we work at. I told him about my business of Juan Pablo's sweeping simulator, and he was like, "Oh, nice job! You know, if you ever need a hand, just call me." And I was like, "Okay, bet." And what's it called? Yeah, and then after that, he just left, and we met again. So if you want to call him and hit him up for your lawyer, call 1-555-SAW-GOODMAN. Pitty, did you hear about the other story about the girl who was pregnant and then her ex shot her? Like right here? In the stomach? He killed the baby, dude. It kind of like broke up. They broke up many times. Yo, get that. Did you get that? The Holy Spirit. It's alive. Betty. What if the dude, what if the, you know in my video, my last video? Bro, what if it's following me? Oh my God. Man, pull up. Straight up. Huh? Ooh, okay, so basically, in my last video, as you can see, I'm gonna pop it right here. I'm gonna pop it up right here. The exact moment where it happened. Look at it. Well. Hola. Mande. Oh yeah, ya vamos a terminar. Yeah, we collected all the trash and it's right here. Yeah. So romantical, cynical. Are you still recording? Holy shit! Oh, hey, shout out to the cameraman. Oh my God. Okay, guys, we almost got spotted, bro. Bro, Pitty, we did not sweep at all. We did not sweep that good, dude. Like the fucking the shit, like okay, I'm gonna sweep it under the table. So there was like this figure, just like, did you tell the face? Did you tell the face? Like, was it a girl or a woman? I mean, a fuck, boy or a girl? With long hair. Or like a demon. With long hair. It was pale as well. Nobody was with me. Only the guy from like who had the like the dogs. That was the only guy who was there. And then when I was coming back, you could see in the middle right behind me that there was somebody walking right behind me. There was nobody with me though. I think that's it, Betty. All right, see you again. Bye. Bye.